Right, good afternoon. International Man of Mystery today is in St Lucia. I'm looking right now across at Rodney Bay, Pigeon Point area in St Lucia. It's not the most beautiful day, but I'm only here for 2 days, so I've really got to get this done. I wish I had more time in the house. We're going to see today the amazing ocean view. Has been previously run as a boutique hotel. 8 bedrooms. I'm told 14 bathrooms, wonderfully big pool, stunning views, looking at $2.2 million on www.barbados-realestate.com, which I think I'm going to have to move my St Lucian listings soon to a St Lucia website. But for the moment, that's where we're at. So we're going to go in. Electric gates at the front, plenty of parking, and this house is being sold as is. So everything you see, apart from one or two personal items, is being sold with a house, which basically means you're getting for your money, and you're talking about 30 odd thousand square foot of home, you're getting in the region of another close to $1 million of... we have dogs barking. Look, getting savaged. Right, walking through. Guest dining on the left. Again, if you look at the guest dining, you see the drop-down window in case it's too windy. Going through to the kitchen, stating the obvious, really, kitchen, you say. And look around, please look around. Everything comes with the property. Again, apart from one or two personal items, everything comes with this property. A lot of the windows are a very solid PVC. Mosquito screens. Most of them have got hurricane shutters. Wonderful chandelier there. Okay, looks like an English country cottage. Anyway, as I turn this way, I show you the view. View is across Cap Estate Golf Course. Very much a full-size pool. As I say, the owner was had this property as a boutique hotel, and it could work really well as a rental property / boutique hotel, either for multiple families, either for single dwellings. As it goes, I hope the wind isn't buffering too much. I feel like James May now on Top Gear. Buffering. I owned a lovely chunk of land down there as well. It's a beautiful down here. I will add a second video tomorrow of Cotton Bay Beach, where they do a lot of windsurfing on the East Coast. Stunning. Very, very well maintained property. Green heart throughout most of it. So we will go now back through the kitchen. I will show you the second kitchen. The owners are absolutely dreaded, do not want to be on this video, but I'm afraid I'm not sure I'm going to be able to do that completely. There you see here, the second kitchen. He said, look, when it's me and the wife alone, this is where we eat, this is where we do our cooking. But in the first one, I laughed. I said, why do kitchens? He said, couldn't get a turkey in there. Pantries, extra fridges. I mean, it's just got it all. It's really got it all. Right, I'm going to go in a slightly different way because I know they really don't want to be in video now. I look left. There's that view again. It's an enormous house. It is a... He joked, but I don't think it was a joke. There's 30-odd thousand square foot. It wouldn't surprise me. It sits on just under 2 acres. Sure if that was open or not. We will look on the outside later. There was this wonderful walkway. And underneath the pool is a room that they were going to turn into a gymnasium or a cinema. And as he kind of becomes mine, I think he said to the tower, he said, I'm not going to do anything. I can't be bothered. So walking back through here, I'm going to walk all the way back to the front. And have my business partner in St. Lucia giving me the look of death. I'm not sure what that's all about. Probably find out after the video. Well, if you hear a wild scream, I think you'll know. It truly was the look of death. Right, coming through here to, as he refers to it, his famous Owl's Bar. Everything stays. Everything stays, including the air gun on the wall. Drum set on the roof. I didn't see that a minute ago. Chelsea Football Club. Oh, God, you can't win them all. Dear, oh, dear. I've got to wind him up about that in a minute, although I'm not sure I can. Three chandeliers. That gives you an idea of the size of this room. It is immense. And again, everything stays. Amazing. Right, through to some of the suites. Little office area here. That opens out, so it could be completely open. Another little office area here. Coming back round. I mean, look at that. I hope that shows up on this video properly. That blue-green hue, as I say in a lot of the videos, doesn't exist. It's just the video trying to cope. It gives you an idea of the view. Now, my hands are steadier. Door on my left's about to slam. Has he caught it? He has. God, it's good. Right, the first suite. Fans, air conditioning. Perfectly well maintained. Nowhere near as yellow as it looks on the video. It's a queen size bed and it's just dwarfed in this room. Walk-in closet, safe in every room. This particular one has got a low-level bathroom, low-level everything for those in a wheelchair because a family member. Sadly, if that's the right word, I know one has to be politically correct, and I certainly don't want to say the wrong thing, and I certainly don't mean to say the wrong thing. Sadly, it is in a wheelchair, so I think the understanding of what is and is not needed was very much dealt with, which is fantastic. And not many people think of it nowadays. Well, actually, that's not true. More people do think about it nowadays than they used to. So walking back through to the main living area. Look at that. Look at this. Remarkable. It's enormous. That ceiling's got to be 40 foot. Right, through to the next suite. Suite number two. Now, you're looking at this and you're thinking, well, it's not that big. Really? Bathroom's pretty impressive. Huge bathroom. His and her showers, if I'm being politically correct, potentially his and his. Shh, you never did. And he goes through to another bedroom. So this is perfect for a family. Connecting rooms, kids in one room, adults in another. You've got your own private balcony. You have another bath, bathroom area and an actual bath. That's very much an English thing, I think. I love a bath. Been living in the Caribbean 20 years and I still love a bath. My wife could never figure that out, but hey. So, other than the private balcony that you have on this side, you also have this balcony here. And I'm actually going to walk from the balcony on this one through to this bedroom because, again, if you did have six of you or something staying, easy. You've got four people in here, you've got four next door, that's eight. Then you've got another bedroom with the bedroom that was connected. Not easy for you to fathom, but you can potentially understand the sheer enormity of this. Big walk-in closet, plenty of storage above. Really well maintained. There's not a lick of paint out of place in this place. Really remarkable. The other amazing thing, for those of you that know my videos, is I don't think I've caught myself in a video yet. I'm considering in a video yet, really, Alex. I think it might mean mirror. Look at that. Little seating area. Brilliant. I'm going to show you this as well. You couldn't help but point it out to me. Look at the look at the length. That curtain rail. It's got to be over 20 foot long. Amazing. And like I say, you've got not only have you got this particular private balcony on this side, but you also have another one on that side. So if you weren't necessarily connected to the people next door, you can close that door off that we're looking at. And anyway, the house is too big for me to go into an enormous amount of detail. I can tell you about the tiles, I can tell you about the maintenance, I can tell you how beautiful it is. The view is to just die for. Here's another suite on this side. Excuse what's on the floor. I've come impromptu today, so. Another walk-in, more safes, and another lovely bathroom. I quite like the idea that I haven't seen two bathrooms look the same at this point. I'm just showing you everything. I know people go, why are you showing me behind the shower room? Because if you're sitting a million miles away in England, in Canada, or the States, or wherever you hail from, you do actually want to see all the property. Not just all the necessarily the good bits, but potentially some of the areas that could be. Oh, did I get myself in the mirror there? He made a point here as well. All the towels you see there, not the dresses so much, of course, but all the towels, all the linens, they all stay. Everything stays. So if you're looking to open a boutique hotel in St. Lucia at an incredible price, this is it. This is the master suite in here. You've actually got two bathrooms, his and hers bathroom. Large walk-in. I'm trying to give you, I mean, I don't like to look in people's cupboards, but I have to give you an idea of the size of it. His and hers bathrooms. Remarkable. Okay, I'm still taking this all in, so I apologise if the video's not quite as good as it could be. This enormous master suite. Absolutely immense. Lovely time of day here. Look at that. Wake up every morning to that. Oh, it could be much worse. It's Cotton Bay down there. A mixed bag, really, in fairness. But a lovely beach, a really lovely beach. You're facing east, but a very calm beach because there are breakers about half a mile, well, you can see, I'm stating the obvious again, that whole real estate thing, but there are breakers about half a mile out, which certainly stop any rough water. Right, I'm now going to show you, that was all on one floor. So, 7, 8 bedrooms and 12 bathrooms, I think I've counted so far, all on one floor. Now we're going to go down. I've got to look at this again, it's just gorgeous. I really am hoping that video is showing up properly. Extra laundry room. And I say extra because I know I've seen one already. Bit of music they're playing. Gonna try and avoid our friends sitting down. Right, heading down here. Non-skid ramp. So people don't end up suing you when they go down to the pool or coming up off the pool. And then down onto the pool deck. Not sure what that noise was. That wasn't me. Right, coming through here. This is an area that they rent out. Oh, there we go, there's another laundry, here we go. I knew there was two. With another bathroom. Now this area here, he still throws events. I'll go this way first, sorry. This is an outdoor bar. Behind there is another bar. It's all very well done, it really is. And another bar here. I used to have a bar in Chelsea. If anyone ever remembered, come the revolution. Fantastic bar. Gosh, we had some fun. A bit naughty at times, but I digress. think I prefer this life though. This is about to become the longest video I've done, but then again, that's hardly a surprise when you've got 30,000 feet to look around. Right, in here, I am told, is a remarkably expensive sound system where some of the stack system are not there, they're upstairs. Still very Christmassy. It's only January the 12th, and this area here, I think, for instance, from my understanding, Scotiabank have rented this out for an event later on, and this becomes their bar for the event, and then you have the pump room. I mean, this will give you an idea. You can actually see the shine in the machinery. I mean, it's remarkable, quite remarkable. And we move on up. This gives you an idea of what the foundations are built into. Solid rock. A different expletive was used by the owner when describing said rock. Right. I'm obviously talking nonsense because I'm enjoying the sound of my own voice. Another suite down here. Little kitchen, wet room. I love a wet room. I don't know why people don't do them more often. I really don't. It's so much better to have it all tiled. It's just... that's cool. This was renting out to a chap a while ago. Single chap, that's all he wanted, so he got a single bedroom. Because the ceilings are low, they use the multi-directional fans as opposed to the ceiling fans. Not a bad idea, because people generally are getting taller. It'd be a horrible thing to have someone's head lopped off while on holiday. Cheery thought. What have we got over here? Ah, this is almost like their machine room. They have spare bulbs, machinery, equipment. Every cupboard is full of pliers, hammers, and this and that, and extra wiring over here. So when they call, and it is a classic Caribbean thing, anyone who doesn't know, you call a plumber, he goes, great, okay. So you go, so you'll start now. Oh no, I've got to go and get some equipment now. Really? Seriously? You wait until then to get the equipment. Now, I don't quite remember how I did this in reverse. And you're thinking, what's he talking about now? Which is going through the walkways, but... ah, and we'll go this way. Dwarf mango. Another dwarf mango. Another dwarf mango. Right, so, sorry, just so you get your... bearings. Swimming pool to my left. Obviously, building to my left. Anyway, we would have come down here. Small storage area here to my left. Coming down the stairs here. This was the room that was going to be either the gymnasium or the cinema room. And like I say, he, for reasons that I'm not going to expound on, he has to go back to the UK. Anyway, I'm not expounding. So, he has to go back to the UK, so he wants this sold, which is why he is able to sell this at a tremendous price. This walkway is absolutely stunning. Look at that. Oh, it just doesn't get any better. I'm gonna zoom a little bit better. Amazing. Pardon? No. Sorry, he's talking to me. So one little nook, gazebo type thing. Land goes straight down to the road below, but as it goes along, it's very hard to tell, I know. St. Lucia, the one thing about St. Lucia is it's so green, it's so lush, that my friend Pippa used to say that all the time. Lush, lush. Anyway, Pippa Pike, lovely girl. Married now, Sotto Grande. Anyway, I digress. So, another walkway. Little viewing stations here, viewing benches. Fantastic. I'm walking very heavily. Another gazebo down there. And a golf, Cap Estate golf course. Wonderful. And then the stairs back up to the way we came. Oh, out of focus. another walkway to the end there, and another lovely walkway down there, which I haven't been down yet, so I think it'd be rude not to. Got it. Neighbour's dog decided I'm lunch. All fully fenced. Goodness me, where does this go? Oh, I see. It gives you an exit out to the road. Fantastic. But it's just lovely. I think it's all green heart. I would have to get that confirmed, but that crunches some leaves below foot. So I think for the video, I should stop there because I'm 20 minutes in. So available at www.barbados-realestate.com. Ocean view, 8-bedroom home / boutique hotel. Brilliant for investment, fantastic private home. I hope you give us an opportunity to show it to you in the flesh.